This is part 3 in a video series where I'm comparing a commercial xenon photo flash to LEDs. In past videos, we've answered the questions, what device is best suited to measure a photo flash, and what is the flash duration of the flash we are comparing to? We've determined that the flash in comparison at 1 over 128th power is 16 microseconds. For all of you photographers out there, that's a duration of 1 over 62,500. So for a fair comparison, I need to flash the LEDs at 16 microseconds. The LEDs that I'm using will be overdriven. That is, I'll be supplying them with a pulse current that is over 700% greater than what they are rated at. I chose not to measure the current pulses, as that was in a previous video. In that, I additionally ran tests on some LEDs to make sure that overdriving them would actually result in a brighter output, which we determined had a logarithmic curve. So the marginal luminance decreases as the current increases. And that is to say, there is a point of diminishing returns. Now in the first video, we paired a 10-watt LED up against the xenon tube, which miserably failed, causing me to have to turn the ISO up just to compensate. In the second video, we used a single 100-watt LED to go up against the xenon flash. While it wasn't as bright as the xenon tube by far, the 100-watt actually produced usable results, giving me hope for the viability in using LEDs for high-speed photography in future tests. As a result of those findings, I've constructed a 2x4 100-watt LED array in hopes to get one more chance against the commercial flash tube. This array will be driven by one disposable flash circuit. Given results from the previous tests, I've determined that this is more than sufficient to drive this array, as the voltage drop across the photo flash capacitor is only a couple of volts. In this test, I will be using the same acrylic disc mounted to a Dremel tool that we used in the second video, that we've determined the outside edge to be traveling approximately 300 feet per second. For this test, we will be using a 3-second exposure with an f-stop of 5.0 and an ISO of 80. The first test is the Yongnuo YN560-3, flashed at 1 128th power. For the second test, we use the LED array with a pulse duration of 16 microseconds, the same duration that we've measured on the xenon flash. Unfortunately, the array was still not bright enough, so we're forced to raise the ISO on the camera. We chose an ISO of 1600 to start. For the third test, we used the LED array with a pulse duration of 8 microseconds. For the fourth, we flashed the LED at 4 microseconds. We then run the test at 2 microseconds. For the sixth test, we flash the LED at 1 microsecond using 140 volts. All previous tests were flashed using 100 volts. For the final test, we're using a duration of a half of a microsecond, or 500 nanoseconds, using 160 volts. We repeat the last test to check for consistency. Having to turn up the ISO to make the pictures viewable clearly proves that the LEDs are nowhere near as bright as the Xenon flash tube. We knew this. So the flash tube wins in this aspect. However, it is interesting to note that the LEDs win in the speed department, as they're able to make the Dremel disk appear to be standing still. We could have chose to overdrive the array even further to get more luminance out of the LEDs, but at the risk of losing $25 in LEDs, I chose to stay at a safe voltage. And that concludes the third and final test.